Здравейте, драги зрители! Ще поговорим за ересите.
Heresies are very dangerous because Paul the Apostle says that they are pernicious. They undo human souls, and that is why we have to be clear about them, to recognize those who have dressed themselves in sheep pelt, but in fact they are wolf plunderers. And so, our desire is to acquaint you, at least partly, with the most dangerous heresies that defeat people's souls and people's health. The truth is only one. There are not thousands of truths. But the devil has concocted hundreds of thousands of lies to deflect people from the truth. In the world there are scores thousands of heresies, and a lifetime will not be enough if we begin to study and thresh them out or interest them at all. But all of them attack the Christian study in the most important things. But even if we or an angel from heaven preaches any other gospel to you than we have preached to you, let him be accursed. Galatians 1:8. Here you see that those who preach the pernicious heresies are under a curse themselves, but they also put under a curse all of their followers. Lord Jesus Christ came to bring the truth for the life to humans. He forewarned us that after the death, a person who believes in him, even if dying, will continue living in another dimension. That is why he says, do not be afraid those who can kill a body, but can do nothing to the soul. But I will tell you who to be afraid of who, after killing the body, has the power to throw the soul into the fire hell. Here, in these important things, heresies attack the Christian study. Some of the heresies that propagate nowadays in Bulgaria preach that after death a person regenerates. The people who believe in this lie of the devil in various forms are a lot. Others believe that after death a human soul implants into another body. His aim is to divert people's faith from the resurrection. And as it is written in the Holy Writ, as Paul the Apostle says, if we do not believe in the resurrection of dead people, our faith is empty. Our preach is empty. This is the purpose of the Christian study. People to believe in the eternal life, and as they believe, to receive it. To believe in the words of the Savior, that is the person who believes in this who sent him, namely the Creator and the Lord of the universe, has passed from death into life, and even if he dies, he will live. That is to say, that life continues into another dimension. When we close our eyes, we see that Jesus Christ have said 100% truth. Here I will divert a little to say what are the defeats of the Jews for not listening to Christ's words. For around 40 years, Saint John the Baptist, Lord Jesus Christ, the 12 apostles, the deacons, and the first Christians warned the population of Israel that a time will come when wars will begin, when Jerusalem will be surrounded by armies. The students asked the Savior, how can they recognize this? And he warned them. And they asked him, what would they do then? And he said, those who are in Jerusalem have to leave Jerusalem and run into the mountains. Those who are out of Jerusalem, not to go there. But when this happens, and then the cities in the Samaria, Galilee, and Judea begin to ruin, the survivors run not in the mountains, but in Jerusalem, hoping that they would hide behind the strong and 18 meters high walls of the city. That is to say that the people of Israel did not believe in the words of Lord Jesus Christ, the apostles, or the first Christians. But a big part of the Judeans did believe. When the war begins, Rome legions subdue and destroy the cities of Judea and Samaria, and after that they go to Jerusalem. There is enough time. 1 year after the war, Nero dies in the year of 68, and the war is discontinued. There is enough time for the people to leave Jerusalem. The apostles and the Christians warned the nation to run out of Jerusalem. But instead of listening to the apostles, instead of listening to the Christians, Jewish superiors call them traitors, and order Christian possessions to be plundered and given to the people who traitor them. The Christians who had believed in the words of the Savior, and Judeans who had believed in the Christians, left Jerusalem and passed through the river of Jordan and went into the mountains, as the Savior said. He said, then run to the mountains. A little before Jerusalem was besieged, the apostles left it and left Judea too, passed the river of Jordan and located in the city of Pella. What was the fate of those who jeered at the apostles and the Christians? Jerusalem was surrounded by an army, seized 1,100,000 people were killed, and about 200,000 are crucified in the vicinity of Jerusalem. Do you see how important is to hear the words of the Savior? But not only hearing them, but doing what He warns us. For 40 years in Israel, a penance is preached, but nobody pays attention. Truly, some had passed and gone in the mountains, and so the Jews are protected. Nowadays, Lord warns the many lie prophets will come, cheaters, heresies, who will tempt a lot of people and will try to tempt even the chosen from him servants. This is what lie prophets, lie teachers, and heretics do. They tempt people not to believe the Savior, so when days of retribution come, to die along with the Antichrist and irreligions. For the wrong address, the humanity is warned at the time of Moses. Wrong address. These are the lying gods who separate people from the God, who estrange a person from the God. One of the wrong addresses is a person to hope and trust to the power of a tree. We are witnesses and have seen people who hold and hope to be healed from incurable illness by kissing and hugging a tree. This is called idol worship. God hates idols, not because they are something, Paul the Apostle says, but because they pull away his children from the truth and push them to the slavery of rages. Many Bulgarians are astray. It is contended that about 3,000 people, Bulgarians, believe in the doctrine of Dun. He teaches that every tree is alive and watches us, and we can love it, hug it, and receive love, receive healing, and so on. At first glance, these people seem amusing to us, naive like the children, but the problem is that when a person hugs and worships a tree, behind it, furies are hidden. As you may see now, I am propped on a tree, but a devil is not hidden waiting to grab me. The worship of a tree gives an opportunity to the Satan to attack a person. Ancient people have made idols from tree, gold, or other stuff, and have worshipped them. They have worshipped lying gods. They are nothing, Paul the Apostle says. But behind these idols, spirits are standing, furies, that are happy when the person does not worship his Creator, but them. And when this is done, the fury has a power to usurp this person, to leave him and continue lying to him, to guide him. So it is possible for some of you, dear Dunham students, who hug and kiss the trees, to begin hearing a speech from these trees. Be sure the trees do not speak. They do not have vocal cords. They do not have this opportunity. But you may hear voices, and these voices to direct you in an entirely wrong direction of alienation from the God and falling into the paws of Satan. Of course, these people go to search help from the doctors after hearing these non-identified voices. Doctors who are atheists cannot understand them, give them a diagnosis, schizophrenia, self-suggestion, assure them that they do not hear anything, but they get into their heads, and so they go to the psychiatry with a diagnosis ear or vision hallucination or the popular schizophrenia. I heard a program that in Bulgaria every third person had passed through a kind of depression.
Това показва,
this shows that we are too bad, that Bulgaria is in spiritual darkness. Of course, as we began with the doctrine of Danov, but it is not his. It is received by all heresies.
Измислени богове в
индийския народ,
които там са с хиляди,
той е
вземал нещо от там нещо
и създал своя учение. Примесил е това учение, наречено пантеизъм,
оговорещаване на предния дърветата на растенията, да виждаме във всеко нещо Бог. Наистина, в Него, в Бога ние дишаме, живеем и съществуваме. Но когато
but
нещо
when something is raised
Бог,
as a god,
това нещо ни
this thing easily estranges, repudiates us from the god, and we actually turn away from him, and then we anger at him. Why doesn't he help us? That is why we will talk about this doctrine of the popular in Bulgaria teacher, in inverted commas, Peter Danov.
Хора като Петър Дънов разчитат на
духовното невежество на народа.
Ние сме
предупредени от Господ Исус Христос в Евангелието, че ще дойдат такива, които ще казват,
че е Той, че е Христос. Със същото идва и Петър Дънов.
Петър Дънов comes like this too. He says that he is the reborn Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ says not to believe them, not to go after them.
Да не отиваме след тях.
Then if anyone says to you, look, here is the Christ, or there, do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will raise and show great signs and wonders to deceive, if possible, even the elect. Matthew chapter 24 23-24. The life was manifested, and we have seen and bear witness, and declare to you that eternal life which was with the Father and was manifested to us. That which we have seen and heard, we declare to you, that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ. First Epistle of John, chapter 1-3.
В наши дни също има.
Nowadays there are these Christs as well. There are Mon, Viserion in Russia, and some others who say that they are the reborn Christ. Interesting is how Jesus Christ is regenerated in a few Christs by the same time. This is a lie of the devil. Danov claims that he will resurrect, that he will raise the same way as Jesus did. In one of his books he says, then you will light a lot of candles for me, and you will want me to come back to Bulgaria, but I will not. The truth is that he is dead, and his grave is in Sofia. Many people know where is it. He had not resurrected or raised, his bones are in the grave. So when a prophet says, 90 prophecies that happened, and 10 that do not. The Bible says that they are a lie prophet. I can calmly name Peter Danov a lie prophet. Clearly, he had executed someone's order, the Bulgarian nation, to be deprived in order to being a victim of the Freemasons, to whom he had served. People like him are all around the world. But let us to pause at this doctrine. Of course, there are things that attract people. Yogas, exercises for perfecting the body and the soul. The morning walk, physical exercises and dances and other things that attract people. But behind all this, a curse is hidden. The curse of breaking God's orders. The biggest evil that he preaches in his Bible is a doctrine of occultism, of spiritism, activities which God has unambiguously forbidden. Not to be found someone who speaks to the dead ones, who calls ghosts, who asks dead people, who calls furies and so on. And he had done exactly these things. Because, says Lord, who does this, he is repulsive in front of the Lord, your God. So everyone of his followers who are in touch with the spiritism, who call the souls of dead people, even saints, even apostles, if they call them and try to speak to them, they become repulsive in the eyes of God. And they cannot expect blessing from him. What is the truth about the Spiritism? Lord Jesus Christ, there was a case in the life of a person called Lazarus. He had lived a poor life, he had been ill, suffering. When he died, the angels brought his soul into Abraham's bosom. Lazarus had died. The body was put into the land. What did the angels bring? They brought the soul of Lazarus, who had gone to peace, who died to rest in the bosom of the father of faith, Abraham. There used to be a rich man who had dressed in purple robe. He had lived luxuriously, had feasted. He had died and had been brought to suffer in hell. While he suffered, he had prayed to Abraham, saying, Father Abraham, send Lazarus to bring me a little water on his finger and to wet my tongue, because I am in a big torment. But Abraham answered, it cannot happen, my child. There is a big chasm between you and us, so we cannot go to you, neither you can come to us. Then the rich man says, then send him to go to the earth and tell to my five brothers to be careful for their lives, not to come to this awful place. Abraham replied, they have Moses and the prophets. They can read and execute. No, Father Abraham, if someone returns from the other world, they will believe him. But Abraham said, if they do not believe Moses and the prophets, even the returning of a dead person, they will not believe. Here, nowadays, we know that there are cases of abducted people. A few years ago, in Nigeria, a person who had a car crash, death was ascertained. Doctors had printed a death certificate. He was sent into the morgue. After 4 days, this person has resurrected and talks to the people in Nigeria. But who believes him? Of course, there are people who will believe him. I believe him too. But those who live like rich men will laugh at him. They will not believe. This is the way of the souls. They cannot walk here and there. With other words, with this example, the Savior says to us that if we want not to go to the bad place, we should not call the people from the other world to come to help us, but to listen and execute the rites. And so, the saints do not appear while a spiritual sense
на окултните практики никакви свети не се явяват. Вие може ли, драги зрители,
can you, dear spectators, imagine and believe that the Holy God will subdue His saint apostles
своите свети и апостоли да отидат
to go and appear at the cause of unclean occult people, spellers and fortune tellers.
Нечестивите окултисти, магиосници и гадатели.
Нима вярвате, do you believe that he will send his angels and saints and subdue them to the spellers indeed? There are Christians who fast, pray and want God to help to send them a saint or an apostle to direct them, to help them, to be always with them or to be as an influential partner in their life. Our sister Maria has prayed the same way for a long time. God to send John theologian, the favorite student of Lord Jesus Christ. One day she had a dream that Saint John theologian came and said, "What do you want?" She replied, "I want you to be my leader, always to be with me, to help me." He said, "I can't." Why? Because you call me to help you, a Russian woman calls me to help her, an Egypt woman calls me to help her. I cannot help everyone. Why? Because I can be only at one place. But who can do it? John replied, Jesus can, because he is a God and he presents the whole universe. He can be at every place. So call Jesus Christ. Maybe here you will have the thought that by the prayer of Sister Maria, John the Apostle came from the other world. No, he just had a dream. You may have dreams about your brother, sister, or friend who is one or two continents distance away from you. He hadn't come to you. God just gave you a dream as this one. He wanted to give you an advice. And none of the soul, spirit, or the body of your friend has passed through the ocean to come to your bed. The same is with the dreams. There are dreams that are from the flesh. There are dreams that are from God, and they happen. But there are dreams from the devil, and they are meant to confuse people. So we have to be very careful and to compare everything with the Word of God. A poet called Costa came to me and told me that he wanted me to connect him with an apostle or a saint. A fortune teller has sent him on Slavka. And she told him, Peter Velev has a connection with the saints, he can connect you with a saint, and the saint can lead you, protect and help you. I opened the Bible and read him this sworn of Paul the Apostles to the Galatians, but Costa jumped, hit the table and said, "Whether you quote Paul the Apostle, I am the reborn Paul the Apostle." I said, "If you are the reborn Paul the Apostle, why do you need me to connect you with other apostles? Paul is one of the greatest among the apostles." This person went away and never appeared again. But before leaving, he confessed that he is a follower of Petr Denov. I will tell you another case. I was invited into the house of a person who worked in the television. His child was ill, and he wanted me to pray for the cureness of the child. I've just arrived at the home, and after a while, a priest from Botonets district comes. Many people from Sofia know him, Father Christo. He and his wife sat, and the presbyter's wife said, "Peter, do you want to hear what is God's opinion about you?" "Oh, of course," I said. "What do I have to do?" "Give your right hand to Father Christo." I gave my hand, but by this time I prayed and said, "Lord, if the spirit that talks from the priest is the Holy Spirit, talk, because your servant hears. But if it's a fortune-telling Satan spirit, let it fall silent and say nothing." We held hands for a long time, and he kept silence. At final, the priest's wife asked, "Come on, Christo, what is going on?" He said, "I cannot say anything." "Why?" "Because he has prayed." After this, we sat on a table, and his wife began talking. "Do you know, Brother Peter, that Father Christo had been a king of Bulgaria in his previous life, and I have been a princess?" "I didn't know," I said, "that he had been a king. I only know that now he is a follower of Peter Denov." Do you understand what happens? Fortune-telling spirit who cheats and lies even priests. This person is now deceased. May it please God, he has repented before dying, but he has lived on with his sermons about the rebirth a multitude of people. Do not lie to yourself. There is no recognition. The Bible is certain. A person is given once to die, and then is the judgment. This is the truth. Once to die, and then judgment. What does the devil aim at the reincarnation? For you to delay the time of the penance, not to repent, to expect that when you die, you will be reborn into a prince, king, president, or something else. Do not lie to yourself. If you do not repent, you will wake up in hell among the devils. That is the truth. That is the cruel truth. Peter Denov has had 12 students and named them with the names of the students of Lord Jesus Christ. It happened that John, one of the students, died. Then his students had come to him and said, "Teacher, we know that you are the reborn Christ, and the things that Jesus can do, you can too, because he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus Christ resurrected Lazarus. You can resurrect John." Denov asked them to leave the house where the dead person was, stayed a while next to John, went outside, and when the students expected to see the living John, he said, "I can resurrect him," and I talked to him, but John doesn't want to. He doesn't want to be resurrected. Do you understand the cheat and the lie? You are not Jesus Christ, and you cannot resurrect. Because the one who redeems is only one. The life is only one. The truth and the resurrection is only one. And he is called Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of living God. Denov is a lie prophet, a lie teacher, who has complicated the mind of many people, and many of his followers suffer from depression. The strangest thing is that they do not have liberation because they do not want to repent. The problem comes exactly from this.
Another lie teacher in Bulgaria
Another light teacher in Bulgaria is the fortune teller Vanga. Are there people to work for Bulgaria? They're all hypocritical. They always lie. Who are they? They do everything, the study. Tell me what will happen in the year of 2000. Occultists try to canonize her for a saint, for a woman prophet. After Publico argues with the high God servant, on 16th of October 1994, the church has been sanctified by the Blagoevgrad Metropolitan Nathanael. The visa of studying and projecting of the church is signed by the late, nowadays, grandfather Pimen in 1992. We were witness when, while building the temple, Aunt Vanga called Svetlin and said, "Svetlin, you will paint images and faces of suffering people in this church, of people who need a help against the illness and health and have come to me for cooperation. This place is characteristic of people with health problems and things connected with health, but not a place for saints. The Triune God and his saints are chased away from this building." To whom do the visitors pray? Why is there a cross after Lord Jesus Christ is not there? If you pray to Vanga, you will connect with a certain power that had controlled the fortune teller. If you search for God, what are you doing in this building where he does not present even as a wall painting? A person from the town of Dupnica phoned and said to me that his daughter is in very bad situation. They are teachers. They came to us and she told me that she hears some voices that speak to her lies, swear her and speak unclean words. She had said this to the doctors, but they had not believed her. I told her that I do believe her, but she didn't want to come to our meeting. She stood at the doorway. Then a woman from Montana came and told me, "Brother Peter, I have been made a plenty of sorceries and the spirits of the sorcerers terrorize me." I asked her, "What kind of books do you read, sister?" And she replied, "I read three books that I have in my bag and I read them wherever I go. They are the books of Liliana Antonova, Vanga and Petr Danov." I answered her, "Sister, you bring the sorceries in your bag and because of this, problems occur." Then this woman from Dupnica came and said, "May I have your attention for a moment? I remembered. I was at Vanga's grave in the mountain of Rupi. When I went away from this place, these voices started talking to me." The media advertised not only Vanga, not only her future, but in the Rupi's mountain, the church there, and now a museum of Vanga has been made. Of course, this is made with a commercial aim, the tourists to go around the rupees, to buy little crosses or other things from Vanga's church, which is not according to the canon of the Orthodox Church, and woe to these priests and bishops who sanctify this church and this pagan temple in the rupees, where Bulgarian people go and desecrate themselves. Do not go if you believe in the living God. Be sure that Lord Jesus Christ is not there. This woman has been affected. I tell you this case for you to run away from this place. There are enough temples, there are enough places where you can pray. God is everywhere. He says to us to get into the hidden room and there, along with Him, to tell Him what our problems are, and He is ready to help us. Occultists try to canonize her as a saint, as a prophet. Her statement that her grandmother has been a princess of Egypt and had been reborn in Bulgaria says that she is also under the power of similar heretic studies. Vanga has told fortunes by sugar. Not only sugar, but all the crystals are used by the occultists, and the devil lies to them that into the crystals words and secrets are reflected, and the cosmos finds the people into the crystals. The truth is that the devil projects himself into images in crystals and cheats the people. The person who wanted to desecrate himself has to sleep on sugar to bring this sugar to Vanga, and when she got the sugar, very often she had said, "Now your grandmother has come from the world and wants to tell you the answer of your question," or another dead person had come. We collide once again with the warrant of the Bible. Not to be found around you a person who makes his son or daughter go through fire, a diviner, a fortune teller, witch doctor, sorcerer, enthraller, or who calls spirits or sorcerers, or who asks dead people, because whoever does these things is loathsome in front of God, and because of these vilenesses, Lord, your God is chasing them away from your way. Fifth Book of Moses, chapter 18:10-12. It is absolutely forbidden a talk between a dead and alive people. Vanga has done exactly this. A lie prophet and a lie teacher. I am a witness to my colleagues who had gone to Vanga. She didn't guess anything about them. But the most interesting is that a friend of mine, Ivan Yordanov, whose sister was hardly ill because of an employment accident, and she was on her deathbed. His mother sent him to Vanga to ask if the daughter will continue her life. When he had stood in front of her, she confused and embarrassed, and everything that she had told him was a lie. He answered, "This is not true, and this, and this." And at final, she shouted at him, "You who are blessed from the God, what are you doing here beside me? Do you hear, you who are blessed from the God? Believers, brothers and sisters, Christians, what are you doing near Vanga and people like her?" Of course, we will not have enough time to give you examples with people who had suffered and people who had been cheated. She cannot be a prophet because she had oracle lies. I remember the World Championship in Mexico. She said that Bulgaria and Brazil will be at the final game. When this did not happen, the journalists exculpated her and said, "Then she was tired and could not guess." The Bible says that a prophet who has told one lie prophecy is a lie prophet. if a prophet had foretold peace, then when the word of this prophet had happened, he had been acknowledged for a prophet who is truly sent from the Lord. Jeremiah chapter 28:9. She cannot be saying true and false things. Moreover, she is given money for her consolations and advices. Recently on the television, I don't remember which channel, was shown a Yugoslavian who had come to ask her something and gave her $500 that she accepted. Prophets that are sent by God do not accept money or gifts for the prophecies. So she cannot be non-avaricious person, as some people compare her with the saint non-avaricious Cosma and Damian. She is just a fortune teller who was directed by a fortune telling spirit. This fortune-telling spirit is a Satan spirit. You say that you are from Petrich. Tell me something about your neighbor, Grandmother Vanga. She became very popular. One day we were coming back from church, and only 50 meters from our house, Grandmother Vanga passed. I said, "Vanga, if you please, come to visit our house. You are only 50 meters from our house." She told me, "Ivan, the spirits do not allow me to go at your house, but Jesus Christ allowed you to come at mine." I told my chief, Apostolov, to go to Vanga's house because she invited us. One day before going there, I prayed, "God, give us blessing for her to welcome us, because when we go there, these spirits might chase us away." I told her, "Vanga, there are always people around you, and we cannot reach you." She replied, "When you come, I will welcome nobody but only you." The same day, we prayed, and God gave us a vision. The vision was that I stand in front of her home. It was darkness inside, and the floor was with floor oil. This means that she works with unclean power. When we went at her place, she went outside and said, "People, if someone is here for me to tell the fortune, please go home because I have dear visitors and today I am not telling the fortune." We stayed together and she asked me, "Ivan, tell me, how does Jesus appear to you and what happens?" I replied, "Vanga, when Jesus Christ appears, I feel as if I am the happiest person in the world, because I receive happiness which is not from the earth. If all of the treasure in the world was mine, I would not be as happy as when Jesus or his angels appear to me. I am given a happiness which is not from the world. Vanga, what happens when these creatures appear to you?" "Oh, Ivan," she said, "I lose consciousness, I fall on the ground, and they speak for myself." "Like, what do you see them, Vanga?" "I see them as black panthers, lions, monsters, the uncleanest animals that attack people, and I am in wretched situation. So, Vanga, let us pray for you. I will tell the church to pray for you to get out of this situation." "Oh," she said, "don't. I am afraid of the Holy Signet. The Holy Signet will raise me in the air." I told her, "Vanga, I was not afraid of the police, and they have pistols and submachine guns. The Holy Signet does not have neither submachine guns or pistols. What are you afraid of?" "No," she said, "they will raise me in the air. Do not pray, but we will think another time." "Vanga, it is very dangerous for a person to go to hell. Their eternal suffering and torture." She said, "They do not leave me. They are with me wherever I go. She had gone to the gospel church and said to the sister, when I go to a place where gospel is read, the spirits go outside and inside I am in peace. When I go outside, they attack me again and get inside me. Many people think that Vanka is a saint. Even a woman from Sandanski had become a believer, but not very affirmated in the faith, and didn't know that going to Vanka is a sin, and had brought another woman there. Vanka had told her, do you know what kind of sin do you do by bringing women to me? Here, you have become a believer, you said in God, by coming here, I am not with a God, do not bring women to me, and had rebuked this woman. Recently, a sister that claims to be led by the Holy Spirit quarreled with me on Lion Bridge in Sofia. I was talking with a priest about God, and she came. We began talking about Vanka, and the sister said, you know nothing. Vanka is a servant of God. I replied, sister, please, if you are sister, I don't know. God has given me a revelation about Vanka, that she is not a saved woman. We should pray God to rescue her from the state, otherwise it is a sin for us. According to the Old Testament, these people are killed with stones. People consider her as a saint. If she was a real saint, the police would not use her. She is their cooperator. She had told it to me personally, because I have seen her a lot of times. She had told me, Ivan, I am in a miserable state, suffering here and suffering in the sky. And what can I tell you? This sister argued with me. I said, sister, do not argue. Read the Bible and you will see that in the Old Testament, this kind of people was killed with stones because they mislead people. And she had misled a lot of people by saying, oh, your person is dead and he is very hungry. Your person is dead. Give him some rakia or wine. He is very hungry. He feels cold. These things are not true. People that are up beside God, he dresses them. They do not feel hunger, cold, or anything. They are similar to angels. They do not eat or drink. But she says things that are out of the Bible. Once I read the Word of God and I lived through, I read on a chapter, then I prayed, and so on. While I prayed, I stand in heaven, one very beautiful area. There was not any like this on earth. I see a nice forest, a nice house, and my mother goes outside it. She came to me and said, son, do you see how beautiful is that our place? Come on, come to us. I replied, mom, I have work on the earth. My father came outside too. Son, I want you to give you an advice. He says, tell me, father, this advice. When you go to spiritual work, wait for all of the people. You talk on not all of the people have come. When they come, you start from the beginning over and over again. Wait for all of the people because I see that you are very tired. I truly am tired. I am like a submachine gun. I cannot wait for the people. Something boils like a volcano inside of me. God has shown me heaven 6 times. I have seen so many inexpressible things. I have cried for death, and Jesus told me that it's not of His will for me to die. But He has a lot of work with me. And so I cannot say, Lord, I want to go to You now. I have told, these years are enough for me. Give them to someone else. But he says that he has worked with me, and so I have to say, let it be your will. And he has shown me heaven for six times, and I said, Lord, show me hell, so to tell people that it does exist. I am in awful place. I saw my grandmother, my mother's mother, in a swamp, and she does like this, to try to go out of the swamp, but she cannot. And then God told me, come and see your grandmother Maria, your grandfather's sister, who is in a big cauldron. I was scared when I went. The water boils. Word of God says, the fire does not die out and the worm does not die. I saw very scary things, but not only this I saw. A big area and people on press, the legs hung. The spiritual body is like this body, but it is from flesh. The spiritual one is not from flesh. It can be eternally in fire and not to die out. But this dies out. It dies. The spiritual body does not die. I was praying again, and I was shown a fire-springing river. The bridge was very tight, and I could not pass. I turned on one side, and then I could. But this is a while praying in my walking hours. And then, on a command, my head turned down. I saw not a river, but fire. I begged for excuse, as worms boil in the dirty, the people bowed in the fire. Fire springing river and millions of people there. These people had said that God does not exist. They didn't repent and went there. It is miserable. I said, Lord, no matter what happens, let us be just one day in your heavenly kingdom. It is a misery for a person to die without God. He goes straightly in hell. He might be very religious, but if he had not repented and newborn, he goes to hell. Once I traveled by the train with some young people. I talked, I cannot be not talking, and they began laughing at me. I said, now you laugh, but I can't even know how you will feel someday. God has taken me from the police. Firstly, I talked about a policeman who has seen Jesus Christ. I said, let me tell you. They said, is this policeman alive? Yes, he is, I said. He is from Petrich. Where are you from? They asked. I am from Petrich too. I know this policeman very well. Oh, they said, that is not true. I am this policeman. These events happened to me, and they happen even nowadays. God has shown me heaven six times, I said. Does heaven exist? They asked. Yes. Hell exists too, I replied. If prison exists, freedom exists also. If hell exists, heaven exists too. So it is your business, your choice. You can choose what to do, to inherit heaven or hell. Sometimes people ask me if it's right for us to pay a priest when he prays for our healing and blessing. You can pay them if you want to, but it is right for them not to accept the money. The Bible calls this simonia. A sorcerer gave money to Peter, the apostle, and said, pray for your gifts to come to me. Peter the apostle replied, you die and your money too, because you have thought that gifts from God can be bought with money. Remember, your rescuing, your healing is a gift from God, without money and pain. We cannot buy the rescue of our souls, forgiveness for sins, or healing of the body. Of course, you may give a donation to a monastery or a church, but when you pay for being healed or blessed, it will have no effect. Because God does not sell His blessings. His blessing is free, without money. Yes, but the church has to be supported, you may say. It has to be repaired. There has to be money for the priests and their families. They have children. Every church has a box where donations are gathered. So it is not right to put money into hands of the priests when a prayer for blessing or healing is done. Of course, it is different for funerals and weddings. There is a price list. It is necessary because the priests are not obliged to make a free wedding. If there are people who want to do it, it is their business and they are blessed. But when it is about forgiveness for sins, when it is about healing the body, money has to be kept aside. They are a temptation. By this you may also know that fortune tellers are not servants of God. A few days ago, one person who suffered from epilepsy came to me. He had gone to many places, he had been in many hospitals. Finally, in Alexandrov's hospital in Sofia, they offered him to open his skull to see what is the reason of this illness. They opened the skull, but saw nothing, and told him, "We tortured you without a reason. We found nothing." At final, they gave him the advice to go to the fortune teller Vera Kuchovska, who might help him, because even the president of Bulgaria acknowledged her with estimable symbol of the president of the Republic, Georgi Parvanov, was given to Vera Kuchovska, the medal which was given to her today, the year of 2006 in Pleven, is for her unusual achievements as a national healer, for her charity and the help she has given to those who needed it. This person had gone to her. She has done a seance, he has paid 40 levs, he has gone home, but his state has become worse. He began collapsing more frequently. He has gone back to her and told her, "Since I come here, my state has become worse." She abused him and made him leave. He persisted, and then she sweared him. You may imagine what kind of a saint is Mrs. Kuchovska. I believe to this person that he had given her 40 lives. She cannot be a prophet. Another lie that is popular among the non-educational people is astrology, that claims to be a Christian science, but it is not a Christian science. It is not a science at all. It is tried to be announced as a school subject. It is absolutely different from the science of astronomy. There is a refused announcement of the German Astronomy Association, in which it distances from thereby called science astrology, because in many astronomical observatories in Germany, letters and questions from astrologers about human fate, about the movement of the stars and their influence on human fate are received. The German Astronomy Association warns all of the people who want to have information from astronomy observatories that they will be rejected and will not be received any information.
И няма да имат никаква информация. Те се дистанцират от астрологията и казват, тя няма нищо общо с астрономия.
It has nothing in common with astronomy.
Астрологията е съществувала.
Astrology has existed even when people believed that the earth is plane. And did not believe to the statement of the Bible that God has hung on earth to nothing. Many people advertise Nostradamus, who has presented himself as an astrologer. His prophecies are written in his labors. And he has written for our century, and when we read them, we see that they do not happen.
He had said that in the year of
1999, a leader from Arabic origin will conquer Europe, and in 1995, the Jewish country will cease to exist at all. You know that Israel exists. There are some lie prophecies that had not come true. I know that astrologers will say to me that he has made a few mistakes.
In
1972, I had a business trip in Egypt, and there were about 20 trade agents
от различни български предприятия.
In the morning, when they received the newspapers, they usually opened the page next to the last and read the horoscopes and lie prophecies.
Хороскопи и лъжливи предсказания.
All of them were members of the Bulgarian Communist Party. What do I want to tell you with this? That this who does not believe into the living God can easily believe into a superstition, into a lie. Astrology is a superstition. Astrology is a lie that claims that our characters, our fates, depends on movement of the stars. A student in France wondered how to earn some money to continue his education, that he can introduce himself as a great astrologer. He had announcements in the newspaper, prepared a horoscope in which he wrote things that people want to hear about themselves. And so they began sending him 2,000 francs for having a horoscope from this astrologist. He wondered that about 90% of people who had his horoscope answered him that they are exactly this kind of person, that he is very exact, and so he gathered money to pay the fee of the university and continue his education. The truth is that to all of these people who wanted to be light, he had sent the same horoscope. This try has been made a few years ago by a German television. They have sent thousands of horoscopes all over Germany and asked them to phone the television if they have guessed indeed and their horoscope is correct, the character, the temperament and fate are correct.
Дали такъв е темперамент и дали такава е съдбата.
90% of the people in Greece have told that these people have knew the truth.
Тогава по
телевизията
бил
показан The horoscope, which was sent to these thousands of inquiries, was read. I will give you another instance. A journalist from a newspaper in the capital city says that very often in the morning he is phoned by people who ask him to dictate their horoscopes because they could not buy the newspaper.
He shares that
the horoscopes which he writes are taken from another newspaper.
Или от стари вестници, за да може да ги изпълни и така.
Представете you can imagine what kind of science is this.
Проверите, купете си
3-4 вестници. But you can check by buying 3 or 4 newspapers in the same day
and compare the horoscopes.
You will see what kind of science is this. And so, dear friends, the astrology is a lie which will turn you aside from the way of faith. Of course, people who say that prophecy of an astrologer had happened will be found. I believe that it might have happened because plenty of the astrologers are directed by fortune-telling spirit. And it happened because you believed in it. I will give you two examples how the faith of in God can bring you health and happiness.
В Бога може да ви донесе здраве, радост и щастие, но вярата
faith in astrology, light and fortune telling spirits can bring you and happiness.
В един дом се срещнах с един генерал и той ми разказа, че на
I met with a general in one home and he told me that the following thing happened and he cannot explain it. His vice commander came to him and asked him to go to the funeral and console his wife when he is dead because he has had a revelation that this night he will be killed. The general shouted at him for being a political commander and believing in these things, but he insisted, and for consoling him he said, well, all right, okay. But when this person went out, a big suggestion came at him. Tonight you will die too. But he stood in the tent and said, no, I will survive. In the night, a battle happened indeed, in which his vice commander died and he survived. He asked me, why did he die and I survived? Because the other person believed and accepted the suggestion of the devil that he will die and gave him the freedom of doing this. Jesus Christ says the devil is a human murderer. He may come in many ways, by suggestion, astrology, or something else. The general has rejected this suggestion, and that is why he survived. Other example, an astrologer meets a relative of mine and tells him that he will be alive when 21st century comes, but he will not live longer. My relative believed to the astrologer, and when the new year comes, he expects his own death, and a few minutes after new year, he dies. What happened? Satan, the human murderer, has given his plan to my relative by an astrologer. He accepted it, he believed him, and gave him the opportunity to undo him. Do you understand what power does the faith have? Faith has the power to make miracles. Faith has the power to heal. Faith has the power to reduce. But faith into the enemy gives the opportunity to undo. So do not believe in similar prophecies about your scary future that will be brought to you by fortune tellers, diviners, or astrologers.
За вашето страшно бъдеще. Ако е трябвало да си знаем
бъдещето, we had to know our future, God would write it on our forehead, as fortune tellers say. Nothing is written.
Нищо подобно не е написано. Нашата съдба зависи от нашето поведение, от нашето отношение.
Our fate depends on our behavior, attitude to the orders of God. Remember this, our fate does not depend on the movement of the stars, on the will of fortune tellers, astrologers, even a little. It depends personally on our attitude to the orders of God. For being healthy, do not go to diviners, astrologers, fortune tellers, sorcerers, bullet pourers, Satanists, vampirists, and all others well-masked servants of Satan. I say to myself, oh dear, what do people believe in Asians? I read in the newspapers about aliens. In Bulgaria it is a descent of aliens. People cannot pass. Do you know what he told me? I forgot to tell you. I told him, all right, you're Satan, with a scholastic circle. Sometimes I circle it. Sometimes he prevails. It is scary. Okay, I said, there is not really a human story. You have dirty all indeed. And do you know what he said to me? God gives an information, Satan gives non-information. A person can follow whatever he wants to. Can you imagine what an insolence? I said, there is no non-information, my friend. I will write this. He laughed inside of me. Who will believe you? They will consider you as a mad woman. I sat and wrote as much as I could, and I sent it. I did not even hope for it to be published. When this thing released, when letters from all around Bulgaria came, they were in two big sacks. Many people came here. I could not explain them. I have spoken with my own words. Some of them believed, others did not. I could not confirm them. Maybe many fortune tellers had been here. Yes, many came, but and plenty of Christians came too. God surrounded me with so much love. These people supported me so much, from all kinds, Catholic, Protestant, Orthodox. All of them wrote to me. Cardboarded boxes with literature was sent to me from the monastery in Knyazhovo. They were worried about me and sent me money to go to Knyazhovo. A priest came, Father Petko, to sanctify my home and said to me that when devil comes against I should say, Satan, go away in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. These things does have an effect. And I feel him behind me. He comes like a fox. And when I say this, he begins growling. Every word in the Bible is true. He is truly like a growing lion, but not like a lion, like a dog. I hope God to forgive me. But the exact word is a dog. And he goes away, disappears, and I feel calmly. I feel something, like something fell off my chest. And he tortures me even nowadays. I hope he does not hear me now. I am very worried about myself. I went to the monastery in Knyazhovo, and people met me so. The nuns stood like soldiers. They met me as if I'm a pious woman. Me, the big sinner. I don't know. They will bake me on the stake like a cat. I cannot rescue myself from this monster. It is very scary. It is a dangerous monster. Someone had prayed for me to be safe the other evening.
Ако слушаш,
if you hear the voice of Lord,
Бог,
your Lord,
добре,
you will be good and live long time on earth. You will be blessed in the field, you will be blessed in the city. God will bless the act of your hands and you will succeed whatever you do. God will bless the womb of your sheep and goats, your own womb and your children and grandchildren will succeed. But if you do not hear the voice of Lord your God, you will be cursed on the field, in the city, and all of the things you do will be everlasting and insignificant and will be spilled on your way if you set against Lord your God. Our faith depends on this, dear spectators. So let's turn to the Word of God to have the Holy Bible in our hands, God's will and His orders in it, and endeavor to execute them for us and people around us to feel good.
И на тия, които са около нас. Да поговорим за баянията, за гаданията, които са забранени от Бога.
A person who tells the future, next, and so on, not to be found. Many people hope to have information from fortune tellers who divine on wax or bullets, divine on the photos of the person with problems. They even divine on sacred images. All of them are led by fortune-telling spirits. It doesn't matter the formula by which they divine. It doesn't matter the occult practicing they use. Behind every fortune-teller, a servant of Satan is standing. Sometimes there might be a temporary consolation or improvement. Sweet and honey is what these people call. Go and find health for this person. It doesn't matter if it is a man or a woman. Go wherever you go and bring health to this person. What are these? Spirits, fallen angels who can bring a temporary improvement to this person, but they know that who turns to fortune tellers gets under a curse, and after this his soul can be taken away. This is the aim. Fortune tellers and the people who desecrate themselves by going them are victims of the enemy, although they can be a temporary effect.
Макар че временно влияние може да има.
We present you the suffered and the honest testimony of a woman who had passed various occult practices. She was stimulated to them by advertisements on the media that without executing the word of God make enlightened people do that sense. Is this fortuitous? In this testimonial, every one of us can survey himself and estimate to whom has he dedicated his life to, Satan or God. Where will you spend the eternity? Today, the choice is yours. Do not delay for tomorrow.
Благодаря на Бога, че имам тази привилегия.
I thank to God for having the privilege. I have wanted for a long time to tell people how my life has passed through many sufferings from a little girl until a grown-up woman. I want to say what are consequences from these scary things which I have done because of non-acknowledge about this way. And I want to warn everyone who listens not to go the way I have walked. After living with this woman who continued divining us, pouring bullets.
Даниле, щом нещо ни станеше, майка я викаше нея. И всички
хора, something happened, my mother called her, and not only my family, all the people from the neighborhood did. She crossed herself, prayed to God, and I believed that all these things are right. When I grew up and I had problems at school, when I got ill in my home, began appearing things which I did not know, which I don't know where did they come from. For instance, frogs were put in our house, various unclean things in our pockets. I knew that these things are spells and began looking for solving the problems with the help of fortune tellers. After beginning in the high school, I had problems, and I went to a diviner who gives roots and problems are solved by these roots. After my marriage, this became more serious. We had many scandals in my family. We could not succeed. And I believe that that was because of the spellers against our home. Both with my husband, we began searching help from fortune tellers and diviners. When things became worse, I could not understand what is the reason, and began going to another diviners. And so, until my children grew up, things were going worse and worse.
Аз не можех да разбера коя е причината, след като вярваха в тези нечисти сили от незнание, и продължавах да търся места пък на, от този, като не ми помогне този, примерно гледач или врач, почвах да ходя при други. И така, докато вече пораснаха и децата, нещата вървяха от зле на зле. Казаха ми за някаква гледачка и врачка,
която... My parents died when I was young and I suffered. I was told about a fortune teller who speaks with dead people. I went to this woman to ask her for the reason my parents died, although I knew it was from the sorceries. She said the names and some things which I believed that were true and began talking to other people. But the situation in the family did not improve, but got worse. We had scandals without any reason every day. The situation became worse even with my sons. When I understood that help does not come from people that I go to,
от никъде няма помощ, от всички тези, които ходех, аз започнах да търся
подходящи помощ. I went to imam in Haskell. This person gave us various of unclean things to put in our meal,
за да може семейството ни да се примири, всички тези неща да се оправят. И това, което аз го правих,
for our family to become calm.
Нещата не се оправяха.
I did this thing, but nothing improved. After that, I went to an imam in Lados, Sofia. An infection did not come from there too. After this, I went to a gypsy woman, a man who improved problems caused by sorceries. Nothing happened.
И впоследствие на време,
after some time, I heard about a woman from Пазарджик, Щерона, who has a crew of people who walk along with her. I knew this from a newspaper, and I used to think that everything in newspapers and on television is correct. I invited these people at home, and she put on the table some quicksilver.
И затова животът ви върви така.
Hair and plumage. She said that everything is caused by the spells, and that is why our life
а те интелигентни хора ходят с някакви костюмирани жени, които да носят мушки и казват, вижте тези мушки, те ни помагат и ни пазят
village,
живота.
And when she released this stuff again, which she said she digs,
той също ни даде мушки.
The people with her are intelligent. They wear suits and bring amulets and say, look at this, they help us and save our lives. When I went to the imam in high school, he gave us amulets too and told us never to put them in water or fire or not to. threw them in a toilet because it's dangerous. I kept all these things with a big fear of happening something worse. But things became worse and worse. When my older son suddenly got ill, I did not know what happened. I did not know the reason, and called this woman Sterona from Pazarjik again. I went to all the fortune tellers I have gone. I cannot enumerate them, because they are a lot. I have not gone, only whatever I have not heard about. Everything that I have done was a great death sin. I see so many people like me, doctors, midwives, educated and uneducated people. I have gone to priests and botanists who had believed in the rebirth, and I saw how bad he had lived. I understood that this does not lead to a good life, but I did not know where to go. I wondered why things did not go better, although these people promised that the things they do will console people and improve their lives. And all of us who used to go there believed. Unfortunately, nothing happened in my life. When my son got ill, I went to the fortune teller Nelly. I have to mention her, because she does not know, but she does a death sense. Now she is in Trudovac. She is near to my village. I want to tell everyone who hears and watches me that she is a woman who thinks that she does the will of God. But this is an act of the devil. In the life of her and people like her, they were worse. They are deluded, and if they do not repent, they go directly to the place where it's too scratching and hair tearing. I say this with a conviction. I am a believer for 7 years. I have told everyone what have these fortune tellers done. But now I want to tell people to go to the way backwards and not to go the way I have walked. Because if you lead them straightly in hell, Bible says that everyone who does occult stuff and those who go to them are doing a death sin and belong to destruction. When this woman did not help, she told me the following. I will send you to another woman. She will untie you, your spouse, because I cannot do this. I only help people. I went to that woman. She was rounding some beads and spoke something. She told us that things will get better. But when we went back home, we threw our mattresses in the river of Iskar, because things got worse. And when I asked them for help, they said, the sorcery is in the mattresses. My son told me, I cannot enter. What I could and I cannot control myself. I did not know what kind of power was this and went to doctors, but nobody knew. I even went to a doctor who works in my soul. I do not want to say her name because she might be offended. I want to tell everyone who goes to her to know that she goes to fortune tellers. This woman began giving us cures. She recommended us a special pharmacy, and my son took cures from there. Our last hope was in the doctors, but nobody could help us. I have gone to all doctors. We have been given so many cures. Effect did not come. We have called ambulance cars in the middle of the night. One evening, my son told me, Mom, do not be afraid because I cannot control myself and I will do something. I said to myself, Lord, shall we go again to this doctor in a soul or not? Because my son insisted to go. In the night, he fell asleep for a while, and by the morning he told me, Mom, I saw doctor who came into our home. He was with white apron, and I knew he was an expert. I went to him and told my illness, and he held my neck and said, here is your illness. Then I said, I do not know what more to do.
И отиваме в НДК-то на Божията църква и брат Петър Велев,
който сега е в дружба и където се води предаването.
I saw this in my dream, said my son. We went to a church in the National Palace of Culture and saw brother Peter Velez. I knew him before this event, but my son did not. In a moment, he said to me, Mom, this person held my neck and said to myself that I should not go to fortune tellers and doctors because God who can help us. Doctors are from God, but they cannot help every time. They cannot heal cancer in the 3 or more days that are left for a person to live. They cannot heal paralyzed people. They cannot heal illnesses in the bones. They say, we are done, we can do nothing more. A faith that only God can help me came in me. By this time, I had been going to church. I said to God, Lord, show me the right way, because I don't know where to go. After a few days, I saw a boy in the bus, and he asked me if I believe in God. By this time, I was reading a book about herbs because I like gathering them. I said that I believed, but I thought if this young and handsome boy will laugh at me. And so we started talking, and he invited me in the Church of God. I went there and listened. It was not like the Orthodox Church. I watched people praying, and I began praying as I could.
Знаеш ли, че за Бог няма
невъзможно? А sister told me, come to the church because God is everywhere and nothing is impossible for him. He healed me from cancer. He showed me the nodule on her neck and told me that her husband had died from cancer. Her mother-in-law had cried because she might die and leave the children to her. I stood on my knees, she said, and prayed to God, Lord, save me to look after my children, and I will serve you. I saw the nodule on her neck, and it looked like a scar. I have seen this kind of scars after surgeries. My faith became bigger. I began saying my problems with the family. They could not be solved by the way I wanted to, but I understood that God can solve my problems. I trusted to Him and began reading the Bible, praying and listening how other people pray. Once I kept the Bible in a wardrobe, but by this time I read it regularly. God gave me solutions so fast that after 2 months my legs were healed. I didn't know how this happened. I went to Brother Peter to pray. Other people prayed too, but I didn't know how it happened. I thanked God for this mercy because I had a lot of illnesses which He healed. I don't have time to count them. I did not pray for them. I just prayed for my legs because I have 3 men in my house and needed to walk. God solved another unsolutive problem with my husband. My son had unclean spirits who are from the fortune tellers. I have led him to them. I have led other people too, and I repent for this in front of the whole world, visible and invisible. What I have done and led other people to do it is a death sin, and I thank to God for giving me the strength to know Him, and I believe that when the people turn to God and say, Lord, show me the right way, He will surely do it. He untied and released my son from the furies, and he began going to work. Recently he told me, Mom, nobody can understand what I have been through. A person cannot understand this until he feels it. I felt such thing, and I knew that that was because of unclean spirits. I didn't know why was that. They threw me, strangled me, I had no power to turn around. I felt like the sky is not mine, the earth is not mine. I didn't know where am I. When I said, Lord, I do not understand, what is this? Because I didn't know where they came from. But when I became a believer and began going regularly to church, to Pavel Ignatov, Peter Velev, where many Christians go, God is where two or three people are met in His name. And I thank to Him. I try to do everything I hear there, and I understand that God is the way, the truth, and the life, because He says, come to me, all of you hard-pressed and burdened, and I will console you, and I will give to all of you leaf water, which you can drink and feel the miracles. Because they are from the living God, they are from Jesus Christ. I used to believe in God, but do you know what my faith was? It was the same as when I meet people and they say, I believe in God too. I have met old people who say the same, but when I have told them that they have to repent for their sins, they say, we don't have any sins. This is the bad thing. They think that they have no sins because they haven't stolen, lied, or adultery. God says that we make sins even with our thoughts, and a person is born to make sins, and there is no one sinless. I thank to everyone who listens, and I try to listen to this now and try not to go the way I did. I thank to everyone who listens and tries to listen now and tries not to go the way I did and not to leave the things I have, because these sufferings have come from the fortune tellers, diviners, imams, and all the people who are occupied by the dangerous things. Many of them think that they help you, but they don't. For example, I said to a woman in my village that I cannot walk, and she told me, I knock to the people, and it helps them. The fortune teller I lived with has a nightmare life. She is now dead, but her family fell apart totally. I know that only God can help them, and talk to them about Him. I would tell the whole world, and I will say this until the end of my life, that only the Lord Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life, and He helps to everyone. Only He is the intercessor between a person and God. There is no other name. I have a letter from a woman in Dupnica who writes that after giving the birth of her second child, it began crying very loudly. A sorcerer had gone to knock to the child, but the woman asked her to leave. After that, she came another time, and the thought of agreement had passed through the mind of the mother. She had left the child in the hands of the sorcerer, and after the spell, he fell asleep. But at this time, a powerful spirit had begun talking to the mother and ordered her, go upstairs and climb the roof. I am your God. She had climbed the roof, and this spirit continued talking to her. Jump, and you will see what a big miracle will I do. I will catch you and put you on the asphalt, and people will wonder, and many of them will believe. By this time, she had heard another powerful voice who told her, go backwards. Why should I? She asked. Go backwards, repeated the voice. She had listened to the second voice, went back and saw her mother, father, and husband standing on their knees praying to God because they wondered where she might be. Do you understand what happens when sorcery is done? A devil arrives and he escorts the child or the mother. So listen to the advice of the Word of God. Do not look for help from fortune tellers and sorcerers. I will give you another example. Two children were brought to me. They suffered from epilepsy. We prayed for them, and they were released. Many years passed, and they grew up. Once I saw their father in the train, and he was very happy. But one day they came again, the mother, the father, and the grandmother. They complained that the epilepsy had come back in the children. I told them that they have admitted something. It cannot be like this without a reason. But they concealed from me and said, no, that is not true. The mother and the grandmother claimed that they have done nothing. But the father said, they lie. Both of them are occupied by bullying pouring. Clearly, these women had earned something by pouring bullets, but the children were loaded by divining spirits and began collapsing again.
The
instances for people who had gone to a bullet pouring, telling fortune, are a lot. And everyone has been depressed after
that.
That is the reason for the depressive Bulgarians. According to a media investigation, every third Bulgarian has lived a depressed. This is the reason, looking for help by enemy. He is who depresses. He is who terrorizes young and old people. Turn your back to Him. Turn your face to Lord Jesus Christ, who is the spring of living water. Go to Him and drink from the water of life. Throw away all of the broken utensils that people might offer you. They will steep you with poison. I completely agree with the decision of the Holy Synod not to be preached other religions at school, because there will be a spiritual poison for the children of Bulgaria. Faith study or nothing. That is the truth, because in the faith study there is blessing, but in other religions there is curse and
depress.
What is the reason why Bulgarian children are getting more and more aggressive? Because they miss a virtue which is called self-restraining. And it is acquired by faith in Lord Jesus Christ and the activity of the Holy Spirit of God.
Тя е плод на Святия Дух. Ако ви интересува тази тема,
if you are interested in faith study, you may learn more by the CD, an opinion about the faith study, which we recorded.
Едно мнение за вероучението, което ние записахме.
Another lie which is popular in Bulgaria is that the study of yoga is a gymnastic, and we can improve our health and have body healing by doing it.
Най-различни духовни и физически изцеления. Зад обаче, зад йогата и зад тия упражнения,
but behind the yoga in these exercises, a spiritual Satan study which undoes human soul stands. I am a witness of people who had practiced
yoga,
after that became believers, and passed through a very hard period of the releasement from the violence of furies. Two Orthodox women were very good students in the yoga school of
Евтимов.
But they got ill. One of them had arthritis all over her back and on her shoulder joints. She had very big pain. The yoga did not help her, but moreover, she said that they had become a great inquisition for her. Her nurse suffered from a headache on which medicaments had no effect. The tries with acupuncture and acupressure did not help, but made her state worse. When these two sisters repented and gave up from the study of yoga, we prayed for their healing, and only for a night, the woman with the arthritis on her back were healed. Their teacher went to them and told them, "You used to be my best students. Why did you quit?" They replied, "We believed in Lord Jesus Christ and found healing for our bodies and spiritual peace." He thought and said, "As soon as you reach spiritual peace, that is more than yoga study. Why do you need, dear spectators, to torture yourself with yogas when you can go to church, look for God, pray to Him, to heal your bodies, to forgive your sins, to be in peace with heaven and have spiritual peace,
и да намерите душевен мир?"
For those of you who want, may find comments about the peace contract in two of our CDs.
Два наши диска. Там ще научите какво
да правите. There you will learn what you should do to have a peace contract with a heavenly land. And understand that yoga studies and various studies and practices as Reiki and others which are advertised will lead you to the wrong address. The address of spiritual peace is located at Lord Jesus Christ. I am the way, the truth, and the life. There you will find life in abundance. My eyes saw healings of suffering from cancer, tumors, Parkinson, epilepsy, schizophrenia. Lord healed them because those people searched for Him, the wrong address. But by this time, they have found the truth. I have also seen narcotic addicted people who turned to God and found the truth. So you too, dear spectators, do not waste your time. Do not roam here and there, but turn to the spring of life, to Lord Jesus Christ.
Спомням си, че има един българин.
I remember that there is a Bulgarian. He is now dead, called Petr Dimkov, nature healer who used iris diagnostic. I have met him a few times. I must say that he did not guess about me, even got confused. He lived in a humble house in the cross. And in his house I have seen books written by Petr Dunov. We, the people, are constructed marvelously. Truly, Lord Jesus Christ says that if someone's eye is healthy, then the whole body is healthy. Of course, here the Savior speaks in spiritual meaning. If we watch with spiritually healthy eyes, with clear feelings, thoughts and wishes and intentions to a human, but not with a sly eye, then we will spiritually healthy. The root of the Hieros diagnostic is somewhere in China. China old medicine is also very advertised. It is connected with divining by the stars or astrology. Acupuncture and acupressure is also very advertised. Needle pricking and massage on the ganglions called in the East religions chakras. In Bulgaria, in the National Palace of Culture, there was a congress about acupuncture. I remember very well that a Chinese professor said, if you think that by acupuncture tumor can disappear, then you are lying to yourself. The truth is that with needle pricking, a headache or another illness might be eliminated when a ganglion is inflamed and this inflammation is decreased. By this, the ganglion might become better and the pain gone away. By the time of this congress, I was interrogated in First Region Administration, and one of the examining magistrates told me that with acupuncture, miracles had happened, and he could have given me literature about this topic, and I can forsake the gospel and begin occupying myself with Hieros diagnosis. I quoted this Chinese professor, but he said, if he is a professor, it doesn't mean that he knows a lot. What is he hallucinating? These were his words. I didn't say something more, but I thought, well, you, being a cop, obviously know more than a professor. Indeed, that was written in a magazine. I don't remember exactly which. If I don't lie to myself, it was named Health. But nobody reads and listens to the experts and those who know much about Hieros diagnosis, its history, but listen to exalted people and say they knew about my fate. Behind Hieros diagnostic, fortune-telling spirit is standing, that is the truth. A few words about hypnosis. It is known that in Bankia there was a school for learning languages by hypnosis or relaxation.
Научаване езици чрез хипноза. Или релаксация. Познавам такъв човек Лука.
I know a person, Luca, who went graduated the school, but after that he began complaining for being attacked by unclean thoughts. They had tortured him, not giving him a chance to sleep. He suffered from permanently headache. Hypnosis opened a window in the subconsciousness and a chance for a fortune-telling spirit to get inside the person and for him, for being occupied, is given. This spirit may know not only English or German, it may speak a lot of languages. I remember that I have read in a magazine that in Ukraine, by hypnosis, a person had learned the Bible by heart, and he could quote it whole chapters from it. But when a group of Christians met and prayed for him, this fortune-telling spirit to leave him, this person had been liberated, peace had come in his heart, but he could not quote the Bible. I don't know if you understand what I want to tell you. Yes, but he had done a glorious thing, you may say. He learned him to the Bible. Once a gospel Christian had a vision that devil stands on the pulpit and quotes the Bible preciously. Then another devil came to him and said, Master, what are you doing? You quote the Bible? Satan smiled and replied, and so what? Here is no blessing, though I quote
it.
So whatever you learn by this way, you will not have any benefit of it. Run away from this way of studying languages, run away from hypnosis, because the consciousness is lulled to sleep, and what happens through the subconsciousness, a fortune-telling spirit comes.
През подсъзнанието се промъква предсказвателен дух. Същото се прави.
The same is done when a person takes drugs. His consciousness is lulled. When he gets drunk, his consciousness is lulled.
Неговото съзнание се приспива. Когато се развихрят страстите
from the Saturn rock music are unleashed, his consciousness is lulled. And that is the aim of the devil. These methods are used for voodoo spells, for some lie religions, with the aim of appropriation by fortune-telling spirits and claiming for being prophets, those people who practice these things.
Друг вид окултизъм е.
Another kind of occultism is the use of badges. They are wooden sticks or electrodes which diviners hold in their hands and search for treasure or water.
Гадателите ги носят в ръцете си и търсят съкровища или вода. Когато
when the baggage cross, as they say, the strength lines which come from the treasures or water, they react and jump in the hands of diviners. I am a witness to people who suffer from awful headache, away tortures, and in the night time are rumpled by some undesired tenants in their bedroom, and when I ask them, do you search for water and treasures with
baggets?
They say, yes, but this is a science. What kind of science is this? Simply, these people are appropriated by fortune-telling spirit. He knows where the water and the treasure are located, and reacts as raising the baggage in the hands of diviners. When they find the water, they stretch tape line, and the diviner walks on the tape line. It shows the depth of the location of the treasure or the water.
Рулетката показва дълбочината на съкровището или на водата. И аз питам гадателите.
I asked the diviners, how can the strength line or the cosmic rays recognize the parts of the type line?
По рулетката. Как ги познават?
How can they recognize
it? Не могат да ми отговорят.
They cannot answer me because they are convinced that these are strength lines, magnet lines, which race or round the baguettes.
Които повдигат, завъртат багетите. Наистина, когато
truly, when the magnet lines cross themselves from the wires, then in them electromagnetism is produced and they react.
Тогава в тях се произвежда електромагнетизъм и те реагират. Но това е една измама.
This is a lie and the devil knows this process in nature law and now lies to people that the magnetic strength lines raise the baguettes. Divining and measuring the blood pressure with centimeters are the same. A person holds a golden loop or needle and a thread and goes up to the parts of the centimeter which is put on his arm. When it reaches 120, for instance, the loop swings. He measures the blood pressure with the machine and sees that it is the same and he says, here the magnetic strength lines cross themselves on 120. I ask you, who measure your blood pressure by this way, with rings and centimeter, how can the strength lines recognize the parts of the centimeter? Realize that this is a fortune-telling spirit. It is a demon. How can a ring recognize these parts? This is a demon. So you measure your blood pressure this way. Will have problems. You will have headaches. You will not be able to sleep. You will hear tramps in your home and bedroom. It comes from those who showed you your blood pressure.
Психоаналитиците
Psychoanalysts walk on the right way by talking to sick people and make them avow, but that is only the half of the truth.
Но това е само половината от истината.
When a person avows his sins, when he avows what he tortures him, he receives a relievement. But the truth is that psychoanalysts cannot help you if they are atheists, even if you avow all of your sins. They just copy something from the church serving and the Bible.
На църквата и от Библията. Както комунизъм,
as the communism copied something from the Acts of the Apostles. Everybody gets according to his needs. And you know what are the needs of our deputies and those of our brothers from the village, and nobody conforms with the needs of orphans, widows and lonely ones.
И така да се върнем.
So, let's go back to this process. When a person goes to a psychoanalyst and he tells everything what happens to him,
разказва всичко това, което се случва с него, той ще му даде някакви наставления.
He will give him some direction to do. He will try to console him. He will give him medicaments.
Ще му даде и лекарства.
But the problem is that very often these illnesses are body illnesses. But this is a soul illness. The soul cannot be healed by doctors. It is healed by priests, but they don't do it.
Но и те не го правят. Тук там има някой.
Somewhere there might be a priest who does these things as a psychoanalyzer. Sits and speaks with the person, consoles him, and when this person avows his sins, the priest can say, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you your sins. I wash you with the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, clean you from any iniquity.
Очиствам те от всяка неправда. Психоаналитикът
това психоаналитикът cannot do this because he is not a believer. Even if he does it, he does not have the authority.
Затова тичането при психоаналитикът
will round you in the circle of occultism.
Това е кръг на окултизма. Вие ще изповядате греховете си.
You will avow your sins, the enemy will unleash against you, and you will surely have no result.
Естествено е, че няма да имате никакъв резултат. Ето казвам ви примера,
here I give you the example which I started as the beginning with the person Vlado.
Ходил при психоаналитик, ходили при психиатри, ходили при
He went to psychoanalysts, various doctors, fortune tellers, Vera Kuchovska, and had got no rid of the spirit of epilepsy, because for being liberated, the spirit has to be chased away from the body. The person has to tell his sins and pray for forgiveness.
И да се помоли за прошка на греховете. И аз ви питам, вие които
I ask you, who go to psychoanalysts, and turn to psychoanalysts. Do you tell to your patients, repent, pray for your forgiveness for your sins? It will have no effect without forgiveness, because the sin will find you, as the Bible says. Wherever you go, wherever you run, no matter to which diviners, astrologers, or another cheaters, you give your money. The sin will chase you until you go in the temple, avow it, leave it, pray to God for forgiveness, and the things go in the right direction.
И тогава нещата тръгват в правилната посока.
In the bookstores, you may find books about the big power of the white and black sorcery.
За голямата сила на бялата и на черната магия. Много млади момичета,
many young girls or even men dirty their life, ruin their life as going to magicians for having a white sorcery for love. They like a girl or a girl likes a man and goes to the magician and said, I want this person to love me, to marry him, and so on.
Да се ожена за него и така нататък. Не е този начин за женитба.
This is not the way to marriage. The Bible did not give this way for a man or a woman to be loved by tying the mind and sexual impulse and patience. That is what this sorcery does.
И страсти. Това прави магията. Магията за любов е пращане.
Sorcery for love is sending a lecherous demon. A colleague of mine told me what happened in the town of Kukush.
В град Кукуш. Там имало един.
There had been a pub owner who liked very much a beautiful girl, but she didn't.
Но тя не го харесвала. Той отишъл при.
He had gone to the sorcerer and said, please make a spell for this girl to marry me.
Магиосницата срещнала
The sorcerer has met the girl and given her an apple. The girl was on her way to church. She said, thank you, old lady, but now I go to church and I have to have the sacrament, so I will not eat it now, but when I go home. But this girl wanted to make an experiment. She sliced an apple and gave it to the pig. The animal ate the apple, broke the chin, ran around the village, got inside the pub and began jumping on the pub owner. He called the sorcerer and said, "Woman, I told you to make sorcery for the girl, not for the pig." Obviously, this woman has sent a sexual demon. A tortured woman told me a case. She is from town of Samokov. She went to the imam and told him, "I really like this man. I want you to do something so he can go crazy about me and I can marry this slender, tall man." This happened. The imam said, "All right, but you have to bring to me a gold coin." The woman brought it to him. The man fell in love with her, began walking after her. As a result, they married. But a girl occupied by furies was born from this woman. Their home turned to hell. Her husband left her. She lives with her ill daughter, who frequently goes into a psychiatry even nowadays. A time comes when this girl breaks everything possible in the house, beats her mother, and the psychiatry cannot help her. This demon of love has brought this fruit to the family. Do not play with fire. What can be done when something like this is effected? This person has to avoid the sins, to decline from the sexual demons and furies directly without concealing anything. He or she has to pray for forgiveness for the sins. The suffered one has to be brought to church to avoid as well inherited sins, to declare from mother's and father's sins. If the parents feel ashamed, they should tell him. But they have to repent too. That is all. Why good sorcery cannot exist? Good sorcerers do not exist. Don't lie to yourself. A sorcery for death, black sorcery. What is the black sorcery? A magician calls a demon of death who goes and tortures a person, usually bones or soul from a grave or other dirty things are brought, and the home of the object is desecrated.
На онзи, който ще бъде омагьосан.
For the sorcery to succeed, the person has to be casted a spell on and eliminated from God. Magicians know that people who are blessed from God cannot be casted a spell on, but the spell returns on them. It is the same for white and black sorceries either. This demon can begin terrorizing a person.
Questo è agganciato qui, no? Tanto si è agganciato di là, quindi è aperto dentro, no? Poi io leggo le mani qui, qui, leggo i piedi qui al... Si può vedere? Si può vedere questi? E questo generalmente si... Ecco, può legare il braccio, vedete? Legare il braccio di qua di là e i piedi lo stesso a questo piola qui Dunque, e qui se c'è questa cinta perché sono terribili. Questa qui per la vita, in modo che non si muova. Sento nemmeno mettere questo qua, cioè sotto, vedi, qui c'è. Ecco, si vedono in questo modo, si vede. Altrimenti non si legge. E rompono tutto. Ah, dunque, tutto questo, adesso vi faccio vedere cosa sono capace di fare questo qui. Questo può essere una ragazza che va dietro, questo è d'acciaio, questo corrisponde a questo qui, no, corrisponde, vediamo qua, guarda, passo una qui dentro, vediamo se lo troviamo, questo qui, sarebbe questo, vedete come l'ha ridotto? È difficile portare il problema, non è possibile, ha visto?
Martina and her parents have been coming to see Padre Alfredo regularly for the past 6 months. The family has turned to the exorcist in an attempt to solve problems which have troubled their daughter since she was 8 years old. Although Martina comes to the sessions willingly, as soon as she enters Padre Alfredo's bunker, she suffers a violent reaction. For her own safety, she has to be restrained before the exorcism can begin.
Prende l'acqua, padre. Va buona, forza. Ci abbiamo pensato,
The exorcism consists of a ritual first formulated in 1614 and updated by the Vatican 2 years ago.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo.
Vaffanculo!
Signor Gesù Cristo, mio Verbo Eterno Padre, Dio Universo, è di Cristo. Ecco l'acqua del Signore Santo. E dunque Gesù Cristo viene una forza particolare. Dunque ho notato questo. A volte il demonio, quando, siccome l'esorcismo sono come fosse uno bastonate, picchia il demonio, no? E mette l'acqua santa nell'aprire la mano, mi brucia, mi sono accorto di questo. Il demonio è furbo e cerca di parlare per riposarsi. Avete visto mai i pugili? Quando si danno i pugni, a un certo punto si abbracciano, si riposano, respirano un attimo. Il demonio fa la stessa tattica, dunque parla e io invece non bisogna dargli retta. Continuare l'esorcismo, in modo che non ci attregua, sono botte.
Ave Maria, piena di grazia, il Signore è con te. Tu sei benedetta fra le donne. Maligno. Ave Maria, piena di grazia, il Signore è con te. Tu sei benedetta fra le donne. Benedetta fra le donne. Santa Maria, ma libera. Ma Maria, no, maligno, è Cristo più forte. Caccele via. Di la verità.
Di la verità
a questa signora, esiste o non esisti tu? Il demonio esiste o non esiste?
Esiste il demonio!
Come fa a dimostrarlo? Come fa a dimostrare che esiste?
Tutto! Ma questo... Io esisto! E chi non ci crede bene?
Ma questo...
Thank you.
Този демон може да започне да тероризира някой човек.
This demon can begin terrorizing a person, torturing him, scaring him, but he cannot kill him if the person does not agree to be dead.
Ако не се съгласи да пожелае смъртта. Затова, когато имате
So when you have this kind of attacks or feelings or wishes about death or self-murderer, you have to reply with certain no.
I find out
these people can murder themselves. I must tell you that some women use the white sorcery to take from their bleeding and to put in the coffee or the meal of their friend or husband.
Приятел или мъжа си или така нататък, но искам да ви кажа, че
But I want to tell you that the last Saturday a woman
която направила такава магия на мъжа си, а той по някакъв
She had done this kind of sorcery to her husband and he knew that somehow he had beaten her and chased her away. This is the result of these sorceries. Do not occupy with these dirty things, because the result is a demon attack, demon pressure on you, and if you do not repent, eternal fire. God speaks about our sorceries in many places in the Bible and says that He will push them away from the hands of magicians. Because of sorceries, Babylon was destroyed. Because there are many people were occupied by sorceries, divining, astrology, occultism, and you know that Babylon stopped existing. It was located at some distance at the south of Baghdad.
Известно разстояние от Багдад на юг.
И пророчеството, The prophecy is that it will never be recovered.
Така. Бягайте от
So run away from the sorcerers, but if there are people who are occupied by them, then repent sooner. In the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 19, an example is given that the sorcerers brought the sorcery's book and destroyed them in front of the legs of the apostles and repent. It is much that is written about sorcerers. Saint Augustine Felicity recommends the books about sorceries not to be thrown away but burned because they can get into the hands of non-educated people who would want to try the sorceries because of their curiosity and undo their souls. Of course, you may see at Slaveco Square in Sofia books about white and black sorceries. You may see books from Vanga, Petr Danov, and other heresies people. Be careful and run away from this kind of literature, because you will bring a curse at your home. So, that much about sorceries, but you better know that out of the heavenly kingdom, Sorcerers will be. Those who make sorceries will not be in the heavenly kingdom because they ruin people and make them suffer. Or as it is written in the Bible, those who I want to be happy, you make evil things to and make them suffer by being in war with fallen angels and furies.
И накрая да поговорим малко и за
At final, let's talk about much populating topic about Templars and Freemasons. Maybe you have already read books about the secret societies. It is interesting how they, if being so good, are secret. If they do so many good things, why do they hide themselves? Lord Jesus Christ says that a person who does things is walking towards a light, and so his acts are seen that are pleasing in front of God. Freemasons do not go towards the light. They claim to be wise, smart, virtuous, but at the same time they hide themselves. The mission of the Freemasons is global domination. We have no reason to lie ourselves. They dream about new order on the planet in which they are the masters and the order's servants. This revolt against the heaven and the harmony on the planet itself speaks that they are enemies of God. However, there might be gospel pastors, priests, bishops who are Templars or Freemasons. Recently, it is popular a movement called New Age. It is not modern. A little before the Nazis had the authority in Germany, it was very popular there and was called New Order. But now it is New Age. Or as the nation says, from bad to worse because it's bigger. The Templars and the Masons are occupied by occultism. They accept the study about the two equal placed gods, a god of good and a god of bad. This does not exist. There is no other God but the one God, says the Bible. The other God which they honor and respect is Lucifer, the transferer of the light. But he used to be a transferer of the light. Now he is a transferer of the darkness. And that is why they hide themselves in the darkness. You understand that they have plans, protocols, which they endeavor executing. I want to tell you a few sections from these protocols. One of these sections is the youth in the whole world has to be depravitated, the nations too, so God can give them into their hands. This is the study of the Nicolaites. This is the study of the Valaam from the Bible. When Valaak wanted to win over Israel, Valaam told him that it is possible. If he wanted to win over it, he had deprived this nation, and then God would give it in his hands. That is exactly what they do with the various modern music, dances, clothes, bringing condoms into schools. And for all of these things, the mission is one, the youth of Bulgaria to be deprived for being given in the hands of Freemasons after this.
Младеща на България да бъде покварена, за да бъде предадена, да бъде предаден този народ в ръцете на франкмасони. Техната задача е световно
Their mission is global domination.
Разделили са
They have a plan. They have parted the earth to 10 spheres.
Една от тези
сфери. One of these spheres is Europe. Another is Mexico, the United States, Canada, South America, and so until 10, which they have to conquer. And a final, they will have to establish one master of the whole universe. They consider that if there are two kings on the planet, a contradiction will be between them. But if it is one, there will be not any. Do they want or not, they work for the enthroning of the personality Antichrist. A while before the second coming, The personality Antichrist will be enthroned by the Freemasons. He will reign 3 years and a half. He will be uncovered by the Jewish nation, will be rejected, and Lord, with the breath of his mouth, will undo him. Then the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ will come. The time of uncovering the Antichrist is very near. Be careful. Unfortunately, I learned that some good young people, Christians, complicate with Templars and Freemasons and do not think that they go to the enemy of the human.
Че отиват при врага на човешкия род. Разбира се, света
of course, the world will be confused. A big economical crisis will come. It is already coming. Then someone who will offer a project for the life to get cheaper and peace in the world will come.
На ептиния, на мир в целия свят.
This project will be accepted. And according to the saint priests, life will get cheaper, but because of the lack of moral, it will be a great condition for unleashment of all kinds of vices, which a final, the burning of our planet and restoring the kingdom of Jesus, in which blissful will be the people who will live 1,000 years, and then while whole eternity.
В което блажени и святи са уния, които ще живеят първо 1000 години, а след това и при цялата вечност. Заслужава ли си?
Is it worthwhile, brother and sister, to lose the eternal life for material wealth? Is it worthwhile to lose the eternal life for a fame on the earth? It is not worthwhile. Run away from the temptations. Run away from seductions. You don't need money which is earned dishonestly. You don't need the lying fame. You don't need pleasures that can bring you to destruction.
Измамителната слава не ви трябват удоволствията, които могат да ви заведат в погибел.
We need repentance, we need prayer, we need friendship with God. We need a rescue for our souls, a forgiveness of our sins, healing of our bodies and souls, and eternal life.
Изцерение на телата и духовете и вечен живот. Това е което
This is the thing we need most, eternal life.
От всичко, което казахме досега,
From everything we said up to now, I know that our opponents will blame me in non-tolerance, but it is not like this. My wish is these people who are misled to bring them to their senses, to be brought around and come back to our Heavenly Father. We cannot be tolerant to the lie and become liars because of being tolerant. We cannot be tolerant to burglars. We cannot be tolerant to murderers. Occultists, heresy preachers are murderers of human souls. We cannot be tolerant to them. Those who are light, God loves them. Even the heresy preachers themselves. His mission is for the people to be rescued. That is why we tell to heresy preachers, repent. You still have a chance until you die. Repent, turn to God. This is our tolerance. Jesus loves you. We love you too. and feel sorry that so much Bulgarians are confused, complicated in heresies, and travel to hell. If we are tolerant to their errors, we will help and push them in hell. That is why we cannot be tolerant to heresies. Heresies have to be exposed.
Затова не можем да бъдем толерантни към ересите. Ересите трябва да бъдат изобличавани. Апостол Павел пише.
Paul the Apostle writes.
Не участвайте в
безплодните дела. Do not participate in fruitless acts of darkness, but expose them.
Вече ги изобличавайте. Изобличавайте.
When you speak to heresy's preacher once, twice, or three times, let him go, avoid him. Why? Because heresies are infections. That is what I want to tell you about the tolerance. Be tolerant to people from the other religions, ethnicities, but not to the cheat and the lie. Expose them, then Lord will be with you, as we often say.
И тогава Господ ще бъде с нас, както ние често обичаме да казваме.
Let Lord be with all of us. Amen.